All right, welcome to Iroquois Iron Worker, and we have a video today here that we want to work on. So on press brakes and bending steel in general, there's always a certain amount of character in the steel and a certain amount of variation in the bends, and that is one of the challenges of sheet metal. Okay, so we've been building these press brakes now for about 20 years, and we've got lots of machines out there, and over the years, we, because of our experience with dealing with many of these machines and bending, our customers bending literally millions and millions of parts, we have learned to trust these machines. And obviously there's some times where things go wrong and the machine isn't working quite right, but these machines have bent millions and millions of good parts, and we know it. But now you have just bought a machine and you're maybe new to sheet metal or working with sheet metal, and you're getting some inaccuracies in your parts, you don't know the machine, and you're wondering what's going on, what's wrong, is it the machine, is there some other problems? And so that's exactly what we want to address today. What are some of the variations? And so though we know some of these things, we've did some basic tests before, we've never did a test quite like this, and so I'll explain to you what we're going to do and kind of how we're going to find out, and it's going to be the results are going to be interesting to me and you. All right, so I'm going to get the camera here and just kind of walk behind it a little and show you guys what we're going to do. So right here is our right here are our test pieces. Basically, we have a four-sided piece here, and it's gonna have four bends on each one. And so these right here, you'll see somebody wrote same on it, same number one. So these four pieces were cut out of one plate of 3/16 mild steel, and they're all laying the same way on the plate. And so we're thinking that these four parts should bend similarly, because the grain should be running the same way, the thickness should be similar, and so on and so forth. Okay, now, and these three parts, I asked the guys to just find four random pieces of 3/16 laying around the shop and cut me four more test pieces from four different sheets lay in, you know, in random directions. So we're going to we're going to have the machine set here, and we're going to leave it set the same. We've got a second video camera here running on the on a dial indicator, so recording to what the machine actually strokes to, and then after we're all said and done, we're going to go back and measure the angle on the bends and see what kind of variation we're getting. So there may even be some variation in the stroke. Different sheets may have slightly different tonnage, different deflection, and so on, but that is what we want to find out. So we're going to go ahead and turn the machine on, and we'll get started. So we're going to do the four that are the same first. Go ahead. And we're just going to run through all the bends here and video it, and then we'll come back later and check them. We've got them all marked and numbered. Obviously we had something go wrong there on the first bend. What was that? Didn't go to the bottom of the stroke? Okay, well, I'm not sure what happened there, but we're going to keep going and trust something was maybe not set quite right on that first bend there. do have four of these, so we still should be able to get a good sample with that. And that one's 90 exactly. That completes those four. Now we'll keep going through the random ones. But what we're really trying to show you is that, and what we often tell people, is that bending sheet metal is not always an exact science. There's variations in here, and it's a bit of an art, and an art to be learned, and learn how to deal with, to build with some of these slight variations, to design around them, and learn to know what's normal and acceptable. And of course, this is air bending as well. There's coining, there's stamping, there's different ways to do it if you do need more accurate bends. But today, the main thrust is to find out what, all other factors being the same, what the variation of the steel alone is, what the effect of that's going to be. All right, this is the last bend, and we're going to go off camera and do some measurement, do some recording, and make up a spreadsheet and show you guys the results. All right, guys, we're back here with the spreadsheet, and try to get you the information here that is the most interesting to you. Hopefully, if you, you've got, we'll tell you how the spreadsheet works or what the information is here, and you can also look over it and make some of your own conclusions. But we'll point out a few things here. First of all, the reason for this is that we are trying to demonstrate that each piece of steel that you bring into your shop has a certain nature, has certain characteristics, has a certain grain perhaps that causes that piece of steel to bend slightly different than other pieces of steel. Okay, and an operator needs to understand this to really get good parts off of his press brake. I have seen some of the world's best press brakes make really poor parts,
And I've seen guys with really poor press brakes make really good parts. There is still a place for an operator out there that understands sheet metal and what it how it reacts and what it does. Okay. But it's talking about grain specifically. If you would think about a piece of wood, how and it's easy to see the grain that's running in a piece of wood, and anybody that's tried to split or break a piece of wood knows that it's much stronger in one direction than the other. And steel, to a much lesser extent, has some of the same nature and characteristics because of the way that it was that it's been produced and rolled out and so on. And we did manage to find the grain in this piece of in this sheet of steel, and you can see that here. So now, what this is not, guys, this is not a accuracy test of the machine, repeatability test of the machine. We did do the, we did give you the indicator readings here, exactly where the machine stopped. But this also included the deflection and tonnage differences and so on from these different plates of steel that all bent slightly different than each other. And that is the variations you're seeing in the stop. If we wanted to do a repeatability test on the machine, it would look quite a bit different. And we would set it up with some type of consistent resistance that would give us a good measurement. And of course, we would be a little more concerned about the testing the equipment and so on. But we just simply wanted to show you here that these that the variation that we were seeing in the stops was not causing the variations that we saw in the bend. We want you to see and understand that that's the variation in the steel. Okay, so each piece, this is the parts that were cut from the same sheet. Okay, this was the parts that were cut from random sheets. Our first bend, we had a mess up on, we didn't get results. This is the different, this is the different parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the different tabs. Again, this is what the part looked like. Two bent up, two bent down, and all 90 degrees from each other, so we could catch the grain in each direction. Now, incidentally, our video camera taking the indicator readings timed out. We did not get the results from the last three parts, but regardless, these parts, because they were random, we did not pick up a particular pattern from these parts anyway. That was really helpful to us because they were all just that, they were random. But now it was different with these parts, and this is what we're going to focus on and go over. So we laid it out here, each bend with the indicator stop that it matched. Okay. Takes 8/1000ths of travel in 3/16ths material to make a degree of difference in the bend. Okay. Now, in these results, in what we saw here, 90% of the strokes were within 0.5 thousandths of average. Okay. And then we had two strokes that were 1/1000ths above and below, but nowhere near the 8/1000ths of travel, and actually 12/1000ths of travel that would be required to make the difference in this in these two bends. Okay, so here's the indicator stop, and this is the degree of bend that the part bent to. We actually measured each part on the left and the right because there's slight differences even there in the material, and we took an average of those and got those numbers here. So this is really right here. We took an average of each tab, and it's interesting here that these three tabs, up, down and D. They were fairly similar to each other, 89.8, 89.4, 89.4, and so on. This tab, on the other hand, was all of a sudden a degree of difference. And this was two tabs that were bent in the same direction, but 90 degrees from each other. And there is where you see the grain in that part. That's where it showed up. That particular part had a grain that caused it to bend easier in this direction, enough easier, and it had less spring back that it bent 1 degree further than the rest of the parts. Okay, so 88.8 degrees here. That's 1.2 degrees overbent, and this was 0.2 degrees underbent. And that's these two columns here. Actually, the 90.2 was one of the random pieces, but we also see in this column, they bent around 90 degrees. These bent around 89 degrees. And that is the grain that we found in this sheet. So you will see that also in the two bins that were the furthest apart, that the indicator stop was exactly the same. And so the only possible difference there is a difference in the steel. And in this case, just a different tensile between those two bins, a different spring back, different grain that caused that. The machine stroked to exactly the same dimension on those two bins. So there's where you're seeing a character difference in the steel that operators need to be aware of. Now, guys, these plates, these test pieces, although cut from different sheets, they were all cut on the same day. They were all cut by the same process. They were all lasered. And they were all cut from the same supplier. Okay, so they're still fairly similar. Now, you're going to throw a lot more variety than that at your break. You're going to maybe you're going to maybe bend parts that have been cut, that have been sheared, or have been cut by plasma, cut by laser, cut by water jet. This all slightly changes the steel, the character of the steel, and how they bend. And of course, steels from different suppliers, even different ages of steel. And our experience tells us that these variations can be even much greater than this 1.4 degrees that we're seeing. Okay, so this is just part of the education of the operator to understand this. You know, for instance, you could correct this difference right here by simply cutting your parts all laying the same direction on a sheet and setting up a different bend for each tab, and you would adjust your spring back on this particular bend to be 1 degree different than the rest of the bins, and then you would again get consistent results. But if you take parts, if you've cut parts out of different sheets of steel and laying in random directions on your plate and so on, you're going to get some variation in your results. That may be acceptable. It may not, but it's just simply something that you want to be aware of.